Hello and welcome to Rose Plays, Season 5, Episode 10. As always, I'm your host, Orion Moon Rose, and today we'll be starting Episode 3 of The Walking Dead Season 1, The Long Road. Now, before I do get started with the episode, we don't have to say what happened last time, as it'll say that in a few anyway. I would like to apologize one last time for the camera issues. I did, however, learn that even if I can't get it fixed right away, apparently you guys can still hear me, so that is nice, at least. Alright. Enough with the dilly-dally, shilly-shally. Let's jump right in to Long Road Ahead. And a zombie that gets beaten to death with a train, apparently. Five years later. Three months later. 20 more months. Let's jump it up.
On The Walking Dead.
Let's be behind.
Get the gates open! We've got wounded!
I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
You've been good to me and my family. You saved Duck from those monsters. And you stood up to Larry at the drugstore. I won't forget that.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
Those look like the people who raided my
Calm
camp.
Calm down, you're paranoid.
Fuck you!
Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
That's right. I know who you are, and I know you're a killer.
He's not dead! Somebody help me!
Come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it!
No!
Sounds like a car.
Still regret that
one a little
bit.
Shitload of food and supplies back here.
You're right. We shouldn't take this.
The rest of us are taking this stuff.
Don't worry, little girl. Bandits got their eye on that dairy. As long as they keep getting food from them, you'll be safe.
Yeah. Until I kill the farm. Ooh. Yeah, that's not gonna end good. Ooh, we can get another farm. We've already done 2 farms. Okay, we're not getting another farm. We screwed. Alright, game series adapts to my choices, tailors how we play, watches me as I make a fool of myself. So how far ahead are we this episode? The Walking Dead. Resident Evil. Wait. I'm in the wrong series. Ciao. Episode 3. Long Road Ahead. Well, it looks like a long road.
This is our lucky day.
Maybe. They tend to take us by surprise.
Yeah, well, the less I see, the happier I am.
Well, you guys could have just, you know, taken most of them out in the town. Tim's Tools and More. Looks like Home Improvement was ransacked. Tim the Tool Man Zombie.
Man. Lee. Where do you come down on staying or going?
You mean packing up the motel and getting in the RV?
Yeah, we've been talking about it, but have you made up your mind yet?
We should go. The motel's run its course, and it's not safe.
Yeah,
damn right,
major
Max.
Thing you learn from the Walking
the
Dead
RV
series.
Pull over till we see water. And if Lily's dead set on staying, then, well, that's the way it goes.
Oh, an airplane. In the store. Wow.
Okay, just like last time. Over the rig, into the pharmacy, and scrape together whatever supplies are left.
World's falling apart.
We didn't leave much in there.
Hey, we're out of options. Something's better than nothing.
True that. True dat.
Shit.
You okay?
The ladder's come loose. I'm not sure how many more trips she's got in her.
I'm not sure how many more trips we've got in us.
No kidding.
Well, I can tell you I sure as heck don't have any in me.
Yeah?
Still sore?
I took a bullet to the gut. What do you think?
Maybe you should have stayed behind.
I'll be all right.
Think we'll find anything? Ain't much left in there.
You're right. We're lucky we found that station wagon. Despite you getting all high and mighty about it. If we'd hit the road like I suggested, we wouldn't be in this situation.
Yeah, we wouldn't have had to worry about that either.
I'm coming up.
Ladder's right there.
Thanks.
They're blocked by all the fallen concrete.
Huh, I can push the Jeep.
There's no safe way through that mess.
You know what? Let's go ahead and push the Jeep, because why not? Well, what's this? Hmm. Nothing. Really, Lee, is that your,
fallen concrete.
Only word for this episode? I get you, Lee. Well, screw that idea, I guess. Oh, well, there could be more. Okay.
It's completely flat.
That explains a lot.
Looks like it still works.
Lily's not doing so good, huh?
Well, we killed her dad.
We did kill her dad.
I love how nonchalant he is about that. We did kill her dad. Well, I don't think I have a choice but to shove it there. God. Alright, but that still doesn't accomplish anything yet, because I'm not going to try to climb that ladder. Yes, we know. You and the I will remember that. Oh, I see a zombie. Clementine's doing weird stuff.
What do you think?
Christ, I've heard your opinion. What's done is done.
Honestly, I didn't even hear what the question was.
Duck was asking about that guy at Herschel's farm last night.
Really? I wasn't sure it fazed him.
Of course it did.
It was a scary situation for him, Sean dying and all.
I'm just worried he'll always think it was his fault.
Oh, now you want to help me?
You're sure you're up for this?
Lee, I'm fine. I've got this. Give me your hand.
Yeah, Kenny. You might be my best friend in the series, but yeah, I didn't expect that to go well. Let me guess. Okay.
Jesus. Are you okay?
I'm fine. Shit. I'm sorry, pal. I thought it'd be healed up better.
You're lucky it wasn't any worse. You could have...
Somebody else is still alive!
Is that a walker?
Walkers don't scream, do they?
Jesus, I don't think so.
Last I checked, no.
It's a girl. We have to help her.
How? There's no getting to her.
We gotta do something.
Oh, she's bit. Never mind.
Fuck, we gotta shoot her. Put her out of this misery.
They don't know we're here.
What do you mean?
I mean, we leave her alive, and she draws them all to her.
buying us time.
Kim.
Think about it. We're always worrying about the ones we can't see. She stays alive and brings them all out of their holes.
Well, she did get bit. I would like to put her out of her misery, but I don't want to die today, so... Knowing she already got bit... twice.
Good. Let's go. She'll keep me busy.
We'll say they give us some pretty hard choices. Gotta decide between life and death on this thing. I hope I don't have to hear her scream the whole time.
We should be good to clear this place out, but we ain't got all day. Get everything you can out of these racks. Don't forget underneath the counter this time. I'll clear down here and then we gotta go.
Alright, so just grab everything we can. Gotcha. Huh, 8 items.
She's gone. There's not much time now.
At this point, I'm just pressing the button as fast as I can.
I think that's everything.
Wow, we got everything?
That girl didn't die for nothing then.
Yeah, thank God. Kinda happy she didn't die for nothing.
We're still clear. Let's hustle.
Kenny, help!
Oh. No! I'm being door blocked by zombies! Kenny? Oh, you mu- okay.
Fridge!
What fridge? Oh.
Fucking get out!
Oh, good, the airplane pilot, back for revenge. Suck it! Or not! Stay away! Bad zombie! No need to waste a bullet now. You shouldn't be dead.
Let's go, pal.
I'm not gonna question it. Well, I think we wiped out that place. Looks like the bandits have come back a few times. Huh.
You're back. Ben found some stickers in a drawer, and I put them on my walkie.
Hey, sweetie. That's neat. I'll find you in a minute.
Looks like we got the kid on watch again.
What'd you get?
We might as well leave a sign out that says the men are gone. Come and rape our women and children.
Huh. Yeah, please don't.
So, what did you get?
Just what was left.
Which was a lot, actually. Take a look. We're fine, by the way.
Yeah, I doubt she cares.
This will keep us going. If we carry on like this, we'll get through the winter here.
The winter? We'll freeze our asses off here!
Because piling into an RV with you two, after what you did to my dad, is so appealing.
Why wouldn't it be? You know I'll do what it takes to keep everyone safe.
We're already safe.
Take a look at the wall, Lily. That's not graffiti. Those are bullet holes. And we got enough arrow shafts sticking out of it to dry our laundry.
We do whatever is best for the kids. Doesn't that make sense?
It's suicide out there.
We'll die in here.
You're right.
Yeah, I think we will.
See someone sleeping and kill one of us. At it again, are we?
Can it, Carly?
Don't boss people around.
I'm sorry. Somebody needs to make executive decisions for the group, though. And I don't think you're capable anymore.
We're strongest together.
Shut Kenny up in the middle of a sentence.
We're sorry for what happened to your dad, but we're in this together now.
What about the food situation? What about protection? What about when this place falls? Somebody's got to be thinking about this shit.
How has this not been working? We have everything we need.
Because of me, Lily.
That's BS, Kenny. And you...
We deal with shit as it comes, just like we always do.
And when 15 bandits hop over that wall in the middle of the night?
We screwed.
You just gonna deal with that?
Everything that happens to us is another excuse for you to pull this crap about leaving. All I want is a week of peace, of not hearing it.
Do you know how we got these supplies? We got lucky and let a girl get eaten out there.
What?
Some girl came screaming out of an alley. She had dead hanging all over her. She gave us enough time to get everything we could out of the drugstore.
And you just let her suffer like what? Like bait? God, what is happening?
It was a mistake. We got our supplies, but we should have tried to save her or put her out of her misery.
Well, you had Kenny with you, so some options were off the table.
Oh.
You should be thanking Lee for not shooting that girl.
It's not so easy for him.
Look, Macon and its people aren't savable. It's not a town. It's full of walkers, and the people who were left are dying and wandering out onto the streets. It's hell on earth, and it's coming.
This is true. Way.
It's not going to be easier out on the road!
How would you know?
What I know? I know you're not above murder. I know somebody has been stealing our supplies. That's right, stealing! And I know the list of people I can trust here gets smaller every day!
Wow.
Now everybody get out!
She might be on the verge of a mental breakdown.
She'll get over it.
She's riling everybody up otherwise.
You understand, Ken.
She's right about one thing. None of this is getting any easier.
No, it isn't.
Things are coming to a head.
Yeah.
Say that.
Well, I think you did good today. And I find myself thinking that most days.
Thanks.
It's probably worth following up with Lily about what she was saying about missing supplies. With her wound up the way she is, I don't want to see her paranoid.
You're telling me.
And I'd like to talk when you've got a minute.
Aye, aye, mon capitan. Isley and her going to get together? Wouldn't say no to it for him.
Hey, Clementine.
Hey, Lee.
What you doing?
What's that you're working on, Clem?
It's called a leaf rubbing. My teacher, Miss Moore, showed us how to do them when we went to the botanical garden once.
Hmm.
See? It's the same. Kind of.
Oh, that's really something.
I'll make one for you, too.
Do you like it here?
I don't like it here.
Do you want to leave?
Where are we going?
Somewhere else.
I don't know. Maybe if I knew where?
Yeah.
Maybe if we all knew where.
Good thing to know. I'll talk to you later, Clem.
Okay.
I love that. Okay.
Hey, you two. How are you doing?
We're okay.
Just having a little spat.
We all carry guns now, and I don't like it.
It's the way it's gotta be.
Yeah, I don't like it either, but he's right.
I'm not getting used to it. I'm sorry. How are you, Lee?
You guys, trust everyone here?
More or less. I obviously have my problems with Lily, but I don't distrust her.
That's good.
We can't turn on each other any more than we have.
About the guns.
Don't you start.
I just wanted to say, Kat, it's probably good they make you uncomfortable.
Thank you, Lee.
But we need them. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah.
You need to try harder with Lily. You guys gotta straighten this out.
I don't know how straight we can get it, given all that's happened.
So what then?
Time will come, we'll have to do what's best for our families. And that's what we'll do.
I'll talk to you later.
Is there a difference between the two?
Hi, guys.
Nope.
Hi, Lee.
Hi, Lee. I guess let's check this way a little bit. Nope. All right. Let's continue on with the search for people. There's Ben.
Hey, Ben.
What's up, Lee?
Did you ever come down here to Macon much?
I didn't have much reason to. My parents would let me take the car into the city on the weekend. But what's in Macon?
Nothing
kind of
now.
A waste of time compared to Atlanta.
I grew up in Macon.
Oh, I didn't mean to say it's crappy or anything.
Yeah, you probably were.
It's super nice. I mean, not now, but I bet it was.
Kiss ass.
Have you seen anything weird on watch? Is there anybody out there up to anything?
Nope. Really quiet.
Really?
Yeah, totally.
Usually the quietest before the crap storm.
What do you think about Lily?
She scares the crap out of me.
That's a...
I didn't mean that kind of crap storm. Lily's gonna make you crap yourself regardless. She is...
Talk to you later, Ben.
Bye.
Sounds like Kenny actually has that thing running. I'll believe it when I see it.
Ooh. Is there a duck? No duck? No? Duck must be in the RV. Here's something, though. Even if he gets it up and running, who even says it's gonna run? I mean, we don't have very much gas we're going on here, people. Any duck? No? Alright, let's go talk to Carly first. Because I have a feeling that'll progress the story, and I want to talk to everybody first.
Talk to Lily yet?
Nope.
No, not yet. I will.
What I wanted to say was, I've been thinking a lot about you.
I think about you too.
Our group is small.
You're
it is.
Small.
That seemed mean.
You're a convicted killer.
Carly, Jesus.
And I think people should know. Not because they deserve to, and not because you're a bad man. I think the opposite of those two things.
I'm glad to hear.
No, because we're hanging by a thread here, and I can't see Lily talk about you without thinking it's the next thing she's going to say. You don't have to tell everyone, but think about who you trust and take the opportunity while you have it.
You're probably right.
Of course I'm probably right. People might be pissed, and telling them might cause some trouble, but it will be a far cry from what'll happen if they don't hear it from you.
Yeah.
True.
So you'll do it then?
Hello, Lost Without Lost.
I'll let people know. You're totally right.
Good. I think it's for the best.
Well, I'll believe you because I think we got a relationship.
Call me small. Now, is there anything else you want to talk about?
Feel free to.
You really think people are ready to hear about me?
It's not a matter of ready or not. There's never going to be a good time, but there are going to be a lot of bad ones. Right now,
a lot of bad ones?
One of them.
We're living
but
in a universe
different.
Where the dead is the mass
population. Maybe it's worth thinking about who you want to tell.
Do you feel safe here?
Show me a bath with a heated floor and a high-rise apartment and hand me a full-bodied Malbec and then I'll feel safe.
I don't know. This place is fine.
No, actually, Lost Without Loss. It's actually my second time playing through the game, doing it more for a show that I do on YouTube. I've done, like, 4 games.
You, have any thoughts about Lily?
So...
That's about it.
But it's been like a year and a half since I've played it, so I don't quite remember too much of it, so kind of like a first time. Alright, so we want to go tell people. I doubt Clement...
Wait,
she knows!
Okie dokie.
The day you and I met, I was in a car accident.
I remember.
Wow, 3 times. You must have really wanted to make sure you got every alternate choice then.
Committing a crime. I need to tell you now, because I don't want you to hear it any other way.
Okay.
Do you have anything to say?
I don't think so.
You can go on back to your things.
You can go back to your things. Clementine understands what you did while... She's seen me kill somebody. It's understandable, too. You know, I can understand why somebody would want to play this multiple times. It's got good choices, and it is a deep story. I'm going to tell Kenny. Why not? I'll just tell everybody.
Sure, pal. What you got?
It's serious.
Oh, no. What'd the she-devil do to you?
Shut up, man.
That's what I did to somebody.
I was, on my way to prison 3 months ago.
No shit.
No shit.
It wasn't for touching kids, was it?
Oh, man. Come on, man.
I gotta ask.
No. I killed a guy in a fight.
Hmm. Must have been a real piece of shit if you had to haul off and kill him.
So we're straight then.
Lee, look at everything this mess has got us doing now. I'm sorry you went through whatever you went through. Yeah, we're straight.
Hmm. Not gonna tell Katya. We'll go ahead and tell Ben.
Hey, Ben, I need to tell you...
Even though I doubt he cares.
Is it about my watch? I'm trying to do a good job.
You're doing
a great job.
I was, on my way to prison before this.
Whoa, seriously?
What
were you in for?
It's not important.
Oh, I should tell everyone? Why not? I'll go back and tell Katya then.
True. And now you know.
Thanks for trusting
me. If you say I should Lost Without Lost, I'll go ahead and do it. It'll be a nice choice outside my hands. Besides, really, Ben won't forget that. I mean, really, all that's left is Katya and Lily anyway, so...
Can I talk to you about something?
Sure. Is everything okay?
Kenny's like... Grr, don't tell her.
I was, on my way to prison.
Well, yeah, because telling people that I've murdered somebody is kind of pointless since, they saw me murder one of the brothers.
Knew I was a convicted fella.
My goodness, for what? How much trouble can a teacher get into?
Plenty. But it had nothing to do with that. It was for murder.
Why?
He and my wife,
That's enough. Tell me what happened when you were locked in the fridge at the dairy.
Okay.
I held Lily back, and Kenny made sure Larry didn't get up.
What did he do?
I don't want to tell you.
He smashed his head in.
Yes, this is episode 3. I just started it this episode on my show. So,
it's changing.
This and about 2 other episodes. And then my next season, I'm going to go ahead and do season 2, since, you know, I kind of picked them both up at the same time. As relatively, they did come out at the same time, too. Wait, why am I going to go tell Lily or Carly something she already knows? Oh, okay.
I talked to Kenny about who I am.
And?
He was cool. He just worries about his family.
That wasn't so hard, was it, tough guy?
Oh, it was really hard.
I talked to Katja.
How'd she take it?
She was fine, I guess. I think she's more upset about Kenny.
Because of the St. John's? What exactly did he do back there?
Oh, don't you start now. I talked to Clementine about things.
How'd she handle it?
About how I'd expect.
She's tough to read.
She adores you. Don't worry.
I told Ben.
You told Ben? Funny you picked him.
Low risk.
I take it he didn't know what to do with the information.
Not even a little. He's just happy I told him something.
Yeah, I'll make him feel like part of the group,
I'll
right?
Talk to you later.
Of course, as soon as I can get to a save point, stopping point 2, I'm going to go ahead and end it for right now, and then sometime tomorrow or Sunday post this episode. Which, if you're curious about any of it, Lost Without Lost, the YouTube channel I run is also under the same name for Ori and Moonrose, basically same way as Twitch. So, not sure if you care, but Ben is super controversial. Yeah, he kind of is, but
you don't have to.
I kind of like Ben. Don't know why.
You come in here to give me hell or to coddle me.
I could cuddle you. You have to.
You have to chill out.
You think? I'm not going to play the victim, but you and your buddy.
Okay, so you're on the boat of liking him too. Yeah, I know most people don't like him, and they think he's a screw up, and maybe he is, but I mean, in the important times, he does seem to actually do good.
Somebody, one of us out there.
Thanks.
He or she or they have been taking things.
You haven't really been sleeping.
Don't start in on that.
You've been through a trauma, and you're not taking care of yourself.
Counts off, and it's the good stuff. Antibiotics, oxy, fuck, anything with opium in it.
I see the count, and it's fine.
I keep my own. That one's getting messed with. I'm a fucking mess right now, but I'm not stupid. I know what happens if I start a witch hunt.
So you want me to start?
At least you know.
I want you to poke around.
What's there to go on?
I found this tossed into the garbage.
Huh.
We don't toss out equipment, we fix it. You'd only try to get rid of a flashlight if you were using it when you shouldn't.
Okay, I'll poke around a little bit.
Yeah, anything to make you a little less super crazy,
Grande. I'm just
going
to assume it's you.
Ouch, and thanks!
A mystery.
Hi, Duck.
Duck.
Or box of rocks.
I'm sorry? I heard you guys talking.
You need to unhear all of that.
Can I help?
What did I just say?
You're the Grace Detective.
He heard nothing other than mystery
Good
and help.
Lord.
So I'm Batman, you're Robin. You know, that doesn't help Kenny's logic. Of, did you touch a kid?
Okay, you're right.
Yeah.
What do I do?
I don't know. I don't.
Go look around.
I do, and I don't think that they made Duck a likable character.
I'm on the case.
He's a hard one to read, I think, more than Ben is. I just think I kind of like him because it's family orientated with Katja and Kenny. All right, I'm going to take the little circle thing up in the corner as a good sign that it saved, or hope that it did. So, we now have a mystery on our hands, and the dynamic duo will either take care of it or fail miserably. Find out next time. And remember, keep gaming, never give up, and when it comes down to it, make sure you're not being a murderer for the wrong reasons.